my exposure on the back. So I may use a little bit more RF and release the posterior part a little bit more. RF, please. Because I want to increase. So now we are focusing, we are doing our meniscus root repair surgery using a root fix retrograde anchor. This is a specialized anchor that we have developed for the purposes of root repair. And this anchor gives a lot of versatility in the repair of the root to the surgeon. This anchor is not only low profile, but it is versatile. You can use it in very, very diverse scenarios and circumstances. And you can use this anchor for side-to-side repairs also. Supposedly, if you encounter a radial tear in some cases, you can use this anchor in the radial tear repair as well. So what I do is, I will just put my... So we are drilling the meniscus tunnel, meniscus root tunnel. Go. That's it. So you can see that almost it has exited at the perfect position of the root attachment. And from there, the system comes with a spinal needle, which is long. The spinal needle goes into the same trajectory where you have inserted the drill. And then you can just take out your jig, your bullet like this. And now you can see that it is exactly at the place of the root attachment. Now the system comes with a nitinol wire with the chia. Grasp it, please. So the system comes with a nitinol wire with the chia. And when you, and you can see here that the nitinol wire is there. The nitinol, the spinal needle is here. The nitinol wire is here. And I'll just pull the nitinol wire into my place. Now, initially we used to pass the root fix anchor directly through this wire, but we had breakages of the nitinol wire occasionally. So we have added one more step and added this Lupin suture, which is very strong, and you can pass the wire, the anchor, without causing any issues. Now, this is the root fix anchor we have demonstrated. Now, this is a retrograde anchor. If you can see, this is a retrograde anchor. This is the pulling suture, and it is loaded with four sutures. Again, number zero sutures. So what I do is, I will pass it in a retrograde fashion through this. Just be slow in this step. So what we are doing is, we are pulling it from the down, from the tibia. Okay, this is the anchor which is there. You can see the anchor is there. And you can ask your assistant to pull it. Okay, so it goes in. Okay, it goes in nicely. Okay, so you can see that the anchor is going into its place nicely. So you can, now you can see that the anchor is right there, and you need to pull this anchor onto the footprint. Okay, now occasionally if you pull it very hard, this anchor may come out from the tibia. So very good trick is, you put your artery here, so that you don't over pull it. That's why it does not come out into the tibia. And then you ask your assistant to pull it into the tibia. Pull, please, pull. Pull, 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 pull. Very nice, very nice. Stop. So you can see that it is nicely pulled. Pull again. So very nicely pulled. Okay, so it's very nicely pulled now. So now you can see that the anchor is placed at the root very firmly. Now you ask your assistant to hold this sutures, and then the pulling suture you can pull from beneath. So you can see that this pulling suture, hold it, and this pulling suture we have pulled it from beneath. Now the anchor is subchondral, and it has four sutures which are exiting from the anchor, and which will be now used to repair the root portion. Now, if you want to increase the curate, please. Now, if you want to increase the healing, what you can do at this stage is, you can curate out the area surrounding the anchor insertion part to increase the healing potential of the of the anchor per se and for the root per se. Now, this is not a compulsory step, but if you want, you can do it at this point of time. Now, what I want to do now is to repair the sutures through the root. So, we want it to repair through the root. Now, you can, the advantage of this particular system is you can use a lot of permutations and combinations to do this repair. So, what I am doing right now is I am taking the blue one. This stage, the knee scorpion is a very versatile device. It goes nicely through the posterior horn. If you don't have a knee scorpion, you can use a first pass mini. It is little bulky, but it serves very well. Now, regarding the scorpion, you need to be very, very sure that you use this anchor only, because scorpion will not take anything which is 2-0, which is number 2. So, you can take a 2-0 wire through the scorpion, or you can take a number 0 wire through the scorpion. You will not be able to take a number 2 wire through the scorpion. So, that is a very important thing. If you are using a thicker suture through the scorpion, your scorpion needle or the scorpion itself may break and can lead to problems of the instrumentation. So, it is always important. So, this root fix system is very versatile in that you don't need to use any other thing. You can just use it directly to repair it onto its place. Now, here what I'm planning to do is sort of a Mason Allen repair. Okay, so I have passed my first blue suture. Now, I will be passing my white suture into its place. So, Mason Allen suture pattern means essentially you need to pass the 3 suture limbs through the meniscus. So, the first meniscus we have passed is the suture limb, which is the blue one. The second limb we have passed is the white suture limb, and probably we might pass a third suture limb, which is again white. You can use an artery forceps to hold those sutures which you have passed. Okay, so here you can see that we have passed 2, and I'll passing my last suture through the meniscus root at this stage. Okay, so I'll pass it underneath the meniscus, maybe in this region, probably like this, and we are done. Okay, so we are good. So, now what we want to do is we want to tie everything. Now, this will be a Mason Allen repair, because we have 2 suture limbs of the white, which are in mattress fashion, and 1 suture limb of the blue, which is in simple fashion. As I told you, if you want to increase the healing potential here, you might use a curette to do a little bit of curettage at the insertion. So, that will increase the healing potential. It is not mandatory, because we have already drilled a tunnel, and that will lead to a good repair. At this time, you can actually check about the reduction. So, since we have done a good release posteriorly, we are able to do a good reduction mediolateral and anterior posterior. So, technically, we are good, all set for the repair to proceed. You can repair them in any pattern, but I would personally like to do the simple suture first, so that I can reduce the root back to its position. Now, when tying the single suture, it is always better if you tie it on the post. So, this is, just take it out. Okay. So, now we have got the curette, and this curette, as I told you, you can use to prepare the bone in the vicinity. Now, the important thing is, don't use the curette before passing the anchor, because if you use it before, you might make the subchondral area weak and you can have chances of anchor pullouts. But what you do, what I'm doing right now, is to prepare the area in the vicinity of the anchor insertion, and I'm preparing it for healing so that it heals, the meniscus root part heals well. So there is a direct contact of bone at the area of the anchor, an indirect area of the contact nearby to the anchor, which will lead to the good healing. So suction, please. So now at this point of time, I can just use, so at this point of time, I can just use the suction to just suck away the parts of the cartilage which we have curated out. Okay, so we'll just use a simple suction to curate away or the remove the parts of the cartilage that we have harvested. At this point, we are all set to tie our final suture limbs. And as I told you, I will tie it in a particular sequence. I will use my simple suture first. So this is my simple suture, and this is the first thing that I will use. Tying the simple suture will actually lead to reduction of the meniscus root onto the anchor. So you can see that this portion of the root is mobile and this portion of the root is coming to the anchor. Now, the portion of the suture which is passed through the meniscus is taken as post, because I want to reduce the meniscus root onto the anchor. This is very important. This is what we have taken and we have learned from our cuff. So what we are doing here is we are reducing it. So now the important thing that you realize here is it has got a very small and a very low profile knot. So this is actually very good, very low profile knot that we get in this particular scenario, and it also reduces the meniscus very nicely to its root insertion. So this is my first, the sliding locking knot locks it, and then we can pass one or two half hitches to actually lock it into its place. So one sliding locking knot, the SMC knot, and after that we will pass one or two half hitches to lock the meniscus root into its place. So here we have locked it one, and we have locked it two. Okay, cutter, please. So now we can just cut the sutures from there. Now with this simple single suture, we can see that the root which was torn is now reduced onto its place. And the second suture, the white one, we will be using this as the mattress suture to hold it into its position. That is what is the purpose of a Mason Allen suture. Now in newer designs of root fix anchor, we have replaced this white suture with the green colored suture so that there is a easiness for the surgeons to identify the suture limb, and the suture management becomes much, much more easier with the colored suture as compared to this white suture. But this again, structurally, this makes a very, very solid repair. So supposedly if you have a root tear which has a radial component and you have a stump which is lying there on the root, then again this is a very useful modality, because what this technique can do is it can allow you to do a margin convergence side to side repair as compared in the conventional transtibial technique. That technique is not available, and you will not be able to do that properly. So here we have again passed the suture, tied the suture in a mattress fashion, and the root is very nicely attached at its position. Both the sutures are very nicely tied, and you can see the root part which is torn is now attached. You cannot even see the part where the root was avulsed, and you can see it's almost like a native normal attachment of the root that you can appreciate. So if you do it properly, you do the meniscus centralization properly, you put the extrusion repairs, anchors properly, you do a root repair properly, your meniscus is intent to come on the functional position, and the osteoarthritis, the chances of osteoarthritis will surely be delayed for the future. So this is the root fix anchor that we have used, and this is, these are the one Osteonaut X anchor for the body and one Osteonaut anchor X for the anterior part of the meniscus. You can combine it with some sort of chondroplasty procedures. If the lesion is big, you can do a mosaicplasty, you can do an ACI for this. Occasionally, some people ask me when I would like to add an HTO. So whenever I am doing these procedures, these two, the extrusion repair and root repair surgeries, I will always be doing. And occasionally, if the varus is more than 5 degrees, I would add an high tibial osteotomy. Now, this particular system is a boon if you want to do if you want to do both the procedures of HTO and the root repair simultaneously, because in this case, just reduce the temperature, please. So if you are reduce the temperature, please. So if you want to do concomitant osteotomy along with this root repair and extrusion repair procedure, you can do it without worrying about your tunnels, because the fixation of all the anchors is subchondral, and you just forget about these anchors and placement of tunnels, and yes, you can just do your high tibial osteotomies and come out. So it becomes a very, very handy procedure. It's a very, very good thing for the surgeons not to worry about any tunnels while doing the procedure of high tibial osteotomy. So you can add an high tibial osteotomy to this meniscus realignment procedure if you are doing it for a varus which is more than 5 degrees. So you can just do, after this, the surgery you have completed, you can start an HTO. You can do an HTO. This will not only do a angle correction of the osteotomy, but this will also increase or improve the healing rates of the meniscus repair that you have done. So this is the final picture. The first anchor, anterior most extrusion repair anchor, the body extrusion repair anchor, and the root fix anchor for the root repair. A very, very nice repair, and hopefully we can be able to give a good joint replacement free life to this lady for a long period of time. Thanks a lot for your patient hearing. Thank you.